called Global Missions Project. We do indeed travel around the world. I think I personally have been to over 40 countries in the last 20 years. We just celebrated our 20th anniversary in June. Our first project was in June of 2003. And so we are so thankful to be still going for the Lord and having the opportunity to go and share his message of love and salvation. So anyway, we're thankful to be here with you tonight. We do want you to enjoy the music. Some of the things that we do with Metro Big Band when we travel are songs like we just did that are not necessarily Christian songs, but they're connecting songs through the music. And that's what music does, is it connects. I like to say that our music when we travel is a magnet. It's a magnet to people to draw them to us. That gives us the opportunity to connect with them through conversation and sharing. Many people have said to me, how do you use music on a mission trip? Well, that's it. Music is a great builder of relationships for us, and that's what we like to do when we travel to various countries. We've got four more mission projects this year. We're going to Rio de Janeiro in September, to Cuba in October, and then two trips to Guatemala in November and December. We already did four earlier this year, and generally with our teams like this group and like our orchestra teams, we'll do about eight projects a year. And these projects are about 10 days long, and we have a great opportunity to share there. A little bit of what we'll do tonight along with the music is just tell you a little bit about Global Missions Project as well, because that's one of the things that we love for people to know. We're kind of a word of mouth organization. People don't know who we are unless we tell you. And so we're going to be passing some information along to you, and I hope that you'll share that information with many people along the way, your friends, relatives, nieces, nephews, uncles, aunts, anybody that you know, people that you work with, and let them know about Global Missions Project and how God has been using us over the last 20 years. Well, we have a wonderful singer with us as well. You're going to hear from her right now. And this is Tiffany Richter, and she's coming to sing a song called Jumpin' East of Java.
But baby, you got all that beat. Job tells us that before the existence of the world, there was music. For all eternity, it is with music that we will worship our great Creator. And today on Earth, music is a gift used to teach, remember, and celebrate God's revelation of Himself to us. Music impacts our bodies, moves our souls, and lifts our spirits. And because of its universal impact, music transcends cultural boundaries. Global Missions Project uses the gift of music to bridge the gap between musicians and those serving in mission fields around the world. Before any project becomes a reality, GMP has connected with missionaries who are committed to growing God's kingdom in a specific area of the world. Together, a strategy is formed which uses music as a way to build cross-cultural relationships. These connections outlast the trips and become a valuable part of the missionaries' work to build deeper relationships through their ministry. And while GMP has seen hundreds of people come to know Jesus, the real proof of effectiveness is the number of missionaries who ask us to return year after year. And now, beyond music teams, requests are being received for other types of projects. Requests for musical instruments, music supplies, scholarships for children to attend music camps, and for assistance to local churches with worship technology, all for the purpose of introducing people to Jesus. Just this past year in Cuba, GMP projects were among the first to perform in public venues inside a tightly controlled communist country. Opportunities like this only come through prayer and relationship building. You see, our part is to go. God's part is to change hearts. Music is the universal language. Here at Global Missions Project, we speak it fluently. And we use it to tell the world about Jesus.
Well, that's a little bit about who we are, Global Missions Project. And that gives you a little bit of an idea, kind of a little thought on that. And we love to do it. God has blessed us to do it. God has guided us to do it. God has put a desire in our hearts to use this gift of music that He has given us. And we believe that not only these musicians talented because God has gifted them, we believe that God gave us the gift of music. That it's a gift that He gave to us because it inspires people, it moves people, it touches their hearts. And we love that opportunity. Now, this next selection that we're going to play, normally I would do a little setup, a little story setup about it, and I'm going to do it anyway. And but I just want you to know, this is a song that was actually sung by a group called Salvador, and a very Latin group, and you'll get the flavor of it when we play it. But the song is called As David Danced. Does anybody remember when David danced? Do you remember what that occasion was? It was at the return of the Ark of the Covenant to King David and to Jerusalem, ultimately to Jerusalem. And because you see, the Philistines had stolen the Ark of the Covenant in one of their battles when they actually defeated Israel. And they had taken it away, and you know one of the strangest things happened? The whole time they had it, bad things were happening to them. They were getting sicknesses and plagues and everything. And then finally said, "Will you please take this thing back? Because we don't want it anymore." And they actually brought it, and ultimately it was returned. And when it was returned, it was great rejoicing because the Ark of the Covenant represented something significant. It represented God's presence with His people. And His people missed it desperately because they wanted to have that symbol of His presence in their lives. And it says that when David, King David, received it, that he danced. It says it after he embarrassed his wife, by the way, that he was dancing. And Micah was embarrassed by him. But anyway, David danced, and that's what this song is about. Now, this is a real toe tapper. And has your toe tapped yet? Has anybody had a toe tap yet? Okay, all right, good. Okay, well, this is As David Danced.
Thank you.
You know, God actually wants us to have fun in our lives. You do remember that, right? We're not supposed to walk around like this all the time. He wants us to have joy in our hearts, joy in our lives. And music is one of the great tools that he gave us to bring us that kind of joy. And we want the music to do that for you tonight, too. We want to touch your hearts and give you joy. And by the way, if you feel like clapping along, that's okay, too. The toe tapping is good, but I can't hear that, but I can hear the claps. Okay. By the way, I also forgot to tell you that the louder you clap, the better you play. I just need you to know that, okay? So, you've noticed that I've been pointing out to you on occasion that when one of these folks stand up to play a solo, you probably know this, but just as a reminder, it's jazz. We're playing jazz. And when they stand up to play, they're actually composing. They're creating. They're not reading notes on the page. They're actually composing what they're playing while they're doing. They're looking at chord symbols on the page, but there's no notes on there at that point. And so it's become traditional in jazz, right when they finish the solo, just go ahead and let them know that you like it. You know, it's kind of encouragement to the player and say, hey, that was good. That was good. So you do that. And even if you don't like it, applaud anyway, because they need encouragement. You know, so, but seriously, don't be afraid to do it. I'll still encourage you along the way when our soloists do play, because we have some wonderful jazz soloists here with us. One of the reminders that we have all the way through with all of the music that we do is that God is the creator of all things. God is the creator of the universe. God is the creator of us. And even uniquely, though, beyond that, something that I still don't understand, by the way, God wants to have a personal relationship with us. He wants to have a personal relationship with me. He wants to have a personal relationship with you. The God, the great God, the one and only God who created everything, is all-powerful, omniscient, knows everything that we think and everything that we say before we ever say it. He still wants to have a personal relationship with us. Sometimes that's tough for me to understand why he wants to have a personal relationship with me. I'm just being honest with you. But I'm so, so thankful for it. And in his word, it actually tells us that Jesus, our Savior, wants to be our friend. And as I was in the worship service this morning with this wonderful church and singing some great old hymns, that just really touched me to sing those again, I was reminded of this hymn, too. That Jesus wants to be our friend in this great old hymn. What a friend we have in. Amen.
We had another couple in my orchestra back home, and they had been on a project. And they came back and they were given a recap of how it went and encouraging us to go. And they said something that got my attention. They said, as musicians, you have been given a unique gift to share the gospel. And y'all, I was so convicted because I realized God had given me that unique gift. And I was not using it to the fullest by just playing on Sunday mornings. So I signed up for my first trip. I went to Brazil in 2015. And 3 years later, I went to Cuba. And that trip changed my life. And I knew after that trip, I wanted to go on as many trips as possible because there was no better way to spend my time and my money. And so since then, I've been on 15 trips. I have 3 more planned this year. And it has been the biggest blessing of my life. I have gotten to build relationships with people all over the world that I still talk to on a regular basis. I've seen people come to know Christ because they heard the music and heard the message through music. I've built lifelong friendships with these people and other participants. But the biggest takeaway from all my projects is how big God is. He is everywhere. And I know that sounds obvious, but to experience it is profound. So every one of us that goes on a project, we are responsible for raising our own support. And just to kind of give you an idea, every trip is between $3,000 and $4,000. And I can tell you, I could not do that without supporters. And the reality is, not everyone can physically go. Maybe you take care of small kids, maybe you have physical limitations, or you don't play an instrument, or whatever it is. But all of us can be a part of what God is doing globally. So I encourage you to give. When you give, you are not just giving a check. You actually get to be a part of what we're doing through your giving. And so I encourage you to give and be a part of what God is doing around the world. This too can be a blessing for your life, just like it's been for mine. Thanks.
You got a friend in me, and you've got There's within my heart a melody. Jesus whispers sweet and low. Fear not, I am with you. Peace be still in all of life's ebb and flow. All my life was wrecked by sin and strife. Discord filled my heart with pain. Jesus swept across the sheltering leaves, always looking on his smiling face, and that is why I shout and sing. Oh, Jesus, Jesus, sweetest name I know, he fills my very lungs and keeps me singing as I go. Trials fall across the way, though sometimes the path looks rough and steep. I see his footprints all the way. Oh, Jesus, Jesus, sweetest name I know. He
fills my every longing.
Yeah, he's my singing guide.
Global Missions Project, in their beginning, our goal was to take musicians around the world. And that's what we have done over the last 20 years. And by the way, it doesn't include just instrumental musicians. We've taken choirs, we've taken praise teams, and we're going to continue to do all of those things. Anything we can do to use music to communicate the love of God and his message of salvation that he wants to offer to all. And our other umbrella, if you will, is to encourage the body of Christ. Because many countries that we go to often need that encouragement desperately. One of those Jessica mentioned, she mentioned Cuba. I love going to Cuba. I've been to Cuba 28 times on mission projects there. And I can't wait to go back. We haven't been in 4 years because of COVID. And we're going back this October. And I'm ready to go and to see our friends there again. Because we made wonderful friends there going almost every year since 2003. Now, but I wanted to also tell you that we also have other initiatives that have developed for us that we feel like is a great opportunity for us to do. Let's go ahead and do this PowerPoint, if we can, Tom. And we're going to see if this works if I punch a button here. I punched, oh, it did work. Yay! So one of the things that we do in a number of countries where the needs are there, especially with children, is we take instruments. All of those are instruments that are on that table there. And we took over 30 instruments to South Africa this past March to a Christian school where the needs for the kids to have the instruments are so that they can learn to play, but also learn about Jesus. And so many of those instruments, last year we went to Guatemala at the end of the year in December, and we took over 60 instruments down there to be used in multiple ministries where the children are being taught music, and they couldn't afford to buy instruments. the instruments are being given to the ministry for those kids to be able to learn music, but the music is used to lead them to Christ. I asked one of our mission partners down there, I said, so how do you know when it's time to reach out to another kid in this poverty area, this area, impoverished area, where you are serving? And he said, it's time when we have another instrument. I said, oh, we need to bring another instrument. And he said, now I'll tell you this, every instrument you bring will result in a child coming to Christ. Amen? Now, that's a testimony. That's an incredible testimony. So we're often taking instruments with us for that purpose. Right now, because of donations from people just like you, we have instruments that are donated. If you have something you'd like to donate, we'll take them. Unfortunately, they all come to my house. And but that's okay, because we rented a storage facility, and we have over 100 instruments in there right now, ready to go to a variety of places. But you may have some instruments in your closet that a child played, or maybe you played, you're not using it anymore, and you'd like to donate it. And we'll be glad to receive those donations of your instruments as well. And so that's one thing that we do. Now, we've also partnered up with several other pastors who have been writing us consistently from different locations. This is Pastor David Ojolade. He is in Nigeria. And he began to write us because he learned about Global Missions Project and started writing us notes and saying, we need help. And we began to listen and realized that we could be of assistance to him. We may not ever take a music team there, but we realized that what he was doing there was so very, very important in sharing the salvation plan of Jesus to people in Nigeria, all over. They're doing revivals there like crazy, and they need Bibles. And they're receiving some of the Bibles that we just sent them. We just sent them about 60 Bibles, and we're going to continue to try to do that. We need funding for those. We buy those Bibles. We get them through the American Bible Society, and they're delivered directly right there to them, and they get a chance to use these Bibles. Also, there are great needs in his area. He's got orphanages that he supports. They need food desperately. All of this is food. We've been sending him support to be able to purchase food there for the orphanages, for the kids. And not just for kids, but for adults as well. Another pastor that has been communicating with me for the last few years, Pastor Jared Onsongo, and he is in Kenya. And it's the same situation with them. Now, right in front of him, you can't see it all, but there's a mixer board there, and his hand is on a speaker. They needed a new sound system for their church so that they could be able to, their sound system was just worn out for them to be able to share the gospel and have adequate sound in their location. I got through purchasing a new sound system for them through Global Missions Project, through our people who donate to Global Missions Project. So those donations don't just go for our projects, because as Jessica said, every one of these people who have gone with us, every one of these musicians that have traveled with us, they raise all 100% of their own support to go on these projects. So the donations that we receive go to other initiatives like this. And this is also with Jared. We've sent them Bibles on 3 different occasions now. Each time it's been around 60 or 70 Bibles. And here they are passing them out. And Jared has been responsible for starting a number of churches, just like David Ojolade has in Nigeria, starting churches from scratch. This is Elio Mora and his son Leo. Elio is our mission partner in eastern Cuba. He's the one that we'll be going to see at the end of October. During COVID, Elio was personally responsible for feeding 22,000 people. Personally. Developing and asking and requesting and everything. And we at Global Missions Project sending out a note to our people who have been to Cuba and saying, here are the needs there. If you would like to give to that, that would be wonderful. This past November, we sent him $30,000 for the purpose of raising for food and for medicine. They need medicine desperately down there. And so this is some of the cartons and containers of stuff that's at the airport in Holguin, Cuba. And here is a gathering you can kind of see. That included, by the way, generators. We actually were purchasing generators for them because of loss of power. I was in Havana this past March, and in Havana, the power is shut off between 10 a.m. and 2 p.m. every day. They can't afford the fuel to run it. And not only that, the fuel doesn't exist for them to run it. So we're looking for always looking for initiatives and ways to do other things that is truly missions. Everybody understand that?
Yeah.
truly vicious. We have an opportunity to do that. And this is David Gonzalez. He just contacted me about a month or so ago, and he recently was letting me know that they're putting together a youth conference for young people where they're sharing Christ with them and giving them opportunities to learn how to serve in different capacities in the church. And this is their mission, their youth conference. It's actually going on right this minute. And we were able to contribute to that and give them some help because of donations by people like you. So we value that greatly at Global Missions Project. So this is some of the initiatives that we've done. There are more. That just gives you a taste of those things. One of the things that country music that I love to use, especially in cultures that may be a little more close to the gospel, are African American spirituals. Because they're not considered to be necessarily in those countries Christian music, they're considered to be American music. They're considered to be culturally American. But every one of them has a message. It's like Joshua did the Battle of Jericho. I get to tell that story about Jericho and the miracle that God performed and how God has a plan for their lives. Like telling the story about David dancing and how it was retrieved because God worked a miracle there. I get to use the African-American spiritual so many times to do exactly that. Well, this next song is one of those that is called Guide My Feet, Lord. It's one that I wasn't familiar with until the arrangement was sent to us by our friend in Tyler, Texas, who wrote the arrangement. And it's just a lot of fun. And you're going to get to hear some soloists in this and enjoy the music and tap your toe again, okay?
Thank you. Jessica, I knew about Global Missions Project from the very beginning, but hadn't signed up for a project. Until January of 2014, I had met Camp and finally decided to sign up for one, and it was going to be in July 2014 to Hungary. But then I found out I was going to lose my job. At the end of that time, I went to my office and prayed, and Lord, I don't understand. And he said, get up, I've got great things ahead for you, don't you worry. Okay, so I didn't. And then in May, I got called again to go on a trip to Scotland as an emergency. A trumpet player couldn't go. That trip became a trip of comfort and healing because of my lost job. And then in Hungary, I actually heard the Lord call me to this field. As I was playing in vinyl service, I started weeping. And I didn't know why until I heard the Lord say, this is what I need you to do now. Now on that trip, I met a young trumpet player who had never heard about Christ. His family never talked about God. And we got to share with him why we were there. A few years later, I saw on Facebook that he was actually dressed for church on Easter. I praise the Lord for that. He's now a professional trumpet player in Europe. So I go forward, and I've been very blessed to be able to go to Romania, and there is now a young man that is caught the vision of Global Missions Project, and he is now serving, a Romanian serving with Global Missions Project. It's amazing. I've gone to Guatemala several times, 8 times I believe now, and we get to work with a lot of the same youth over those 8 years, and it's been amazing to see them grow. But the Lord also has a way of checking our spirit and making sure that our hearts are right while we're on the mission field. You see, in rehearsal, the very first rehearsal for that trip, I was having troubles with my contacts, and I struggled to get it out. I was in the bathroom, and when I finally got it out, all I could see was gray shadows. I couldn't see any detail, and it scared me. But I was able to make it through the rehearsal with readers and a lot of things to be able to do that. But as I was talking to the Lord that night, He admonished me because of pride. He replayed in my head while I was discussing this with him what I was thinking and doing while I was playing in that rehearsal and how I was so proud of how well we were playing, how well I was doing. And he convicted me to confess to Camp and to the missionary partner that we were there with because they have to trust that my heart is right when we're in the field. And I can share that everyone here is conscious of that. Anyway, the wonderful gift of that trip was in the very last program. All those students we had been working with for the last 7 years, we played a concert or a service, and after the last song, they came running down from the balcony. And they literally were weeping and crying uncontrollably. And they sensed that the Lord finally really made himself clear to them. And they now trust the Lord with their lives. It's been an amazing, amazing journey. And thank you. Thank you for the mission project, and I praise the Lord for conviction and for healing and grace and mercy. Thank you.
Thank you.
This next testimony is on a video. I want to just tell you briefly, young lady's name is Ilsa. She's from Guatemala. And she's been a part of the ministry that we have been serving down there since our first trip there was in 2006. And she's been part of that ministry for a number of years. And I just want you to hear what she has to say.
Dios les bendiga. Mi nombre es Ilsenari, soy de Guatemala. Y quería agradecerle a Dios por tomarme en cuenta en este video y por permitirme poder compartirles sobre cómo mi vida ha cambiado con la música y cómo Global Missions Project ha impactado mi vida. Y a la edad de 12 años, yo fui tomada en cuenta por gracia y misericordia de Dios en el grupo musical del Pastor Manuel y el Pastor Pedro, en el cual a mí se me dio el privilegio de poder ejecutar una flauta transversal. En ese momento yo no sabía de dónde venían los instrumentos, porque hay varios. Y entonces con este instrumento y con este grupo yo pude afirmar mi vida espiritual delante de Dios. Yo buscaba de Dios, pero cuando conocí este grupo, cuando Dios me permitió estar en este grupo, me acerqué mucho más a Él. Y yo puedo decir que no hay nada mejor que entregarle nuestra juventud a Dios. Y qué mejor que entregársela tocando para Él y alabándole a Él con música grata delante de Él. Luego de varios meses de formar parte en este grupo, llegó el mes de diciembre, en el cual hubo una actividad en donde llegaron personas que yo no conocía, que yo no había visto, y que eran de otro país, de Estados Unidos. Entonces, cuando hablé con uno de ellos, me hicieron mención que ellos eran los que donaban el instrumento. Entonces yo veo a Global Missions Project como una fuente de bendición para jóvenes en todo el mundo, no solo en Guatemala, sino que en todo el mundo. Y gracias a Dios por ese grupo, por ese trabajo que ellos están haciendo de llevar no solo instrumentos, sino palabra de Dios. Porque el 10 de día que yo estuve ahí, regalaron nuevos testamentos y tocaron música para nosotros, música de Dios para nosotros, lo cual a mí me dejó sorprendida y con muchas ganas de seguir haciendo música para Dios y comprender que no solo es tocar unas notas, sino que al momento de uno estar tocando es sentirlo, y sentirlo para que Dios vea que lo que estamos haciendo no es no es solo por tocar, sino que es una alabanza que le estamos entregando a Él. Gracias a Dios por la oportunidad que me da de conocer a Global Missions Project y de formar parte del grupo del Pastor Manuel y del Pastor Pedro. Que Dios les bendiga.
Oh,
Me too. We like to come to a close with our times together with music, often with our orchestra. We have an orchestra, by the way. This is Metro Big Band. Our orchestra is called Celebration Orchestra, and it's just a generic name. Because when the Metro Big Band travels, it's a different group of musicians every time, or most of the time. Well, some of the time. Well, let me say this, because I think this is important for you to know. We have a lot of repeaters, people who go and go again. Alan was up here sharing his testimony. Alan, how many?
42
mission projects Alan's been on since 2014. And I want to be clear, the Great Commission in Matthew 28, 19 and 20 applies to all of us. It doesn't mean you have to get on an airplane, but the idea of being a witness for Christ and being on the mission field every day of our lives is really significant. It's something I think we all need to think of. And I will say that when you go get away from home and go someplace else, there's something that happens inside of you. When you realize that all of your focus for that period of time, that week or however many days, that that time is really truly focused on missions, sharing the gospel of Jesus Christ and encouraging the body of Christ wherever we go. So I'm thankful that we have the opportunity to do that. But we often close all of our concerts with this song. This is the one song that unites believers around the world more than any other song. I'm sure if I took a vote in the worship center tonight, I'd get maybe a few different songs mentioned, but let me see. I want to get a real quick. Who would say is that song? What is that song? What's the title? You know what I mean? Yeah, I think I heard it somewhere in the midst of that. I think I don't know if you were speaking in tongues or whatever. I think I got it, and that is it's How Great Thou Art. That song is sung in every single country that I've been in. When they sing it with fervor. They love to sing this song. So we want to play How Great Thou Art for you right now. And while we're playing this, can I encourage you to think back to that day, that moment, that time when you met the Savior. Not when you found out about him, but when you realized who he really is and what he wanted to do for you, and you opened your heart to Jesus.
Thank you.
We do have one more. I don't know if you're ready to leave. By the way, I will say all of these musicians on the stage right now, with the exception of Christine, who is actually attends here, and she wanted to be a part. So she sat in with us, and she's playing with us for the very first time. She goes here. But we had one rehearsal yesterday. This band in total has never played together before. And they're here for you tonight, using their gifts for God, for His glory. And truly, that is our calling and our purpose. You received a blue card thing, that was kind of bluish card when you came in. We wanted to make it easy for you if you feel a tug on your heart to help GMP continue what we're doing. A QR code that's on the front of that, you can scan it with your phone, it'll take you right to our give page. And we'd love for you to jump on the boat with us and be an encourager in any way that you choose to be. But we have that for you. And then we have some CDs out on the table out in the foyer as well. Four of them are CDs of Metro Big Band, and one of them is a CD of Celebration Orchestra. And it's really, really good. I mean, I promise it's good. And I really like it. It's really good. So if any of those for you out there, our ladies are out there to take care of you on those as well. A number of years ago, I was looking for a song to be kind of our finale song with Metro Big Band. And all the songs that I had that I felt like kind of were finale songs, they didn't have a singer on it. I wanted something with our singer to be able to come back up and close us out. And I was looking for the song, and for some reason, I'm assuming God gave me this song. That's what I mean. I didn't write it, but I mean, I'm assuming that He gave me this title. The name of it is Get Happy. Y'all remember that song? Forget Your Troubles, Come On, Get Happy. Oh, I'm sorry, she's supposed to sing it, not me. But remember what it says? It says, get ready for the judgment day. There's a long, look that song up, see how it was written, what it was written for. It was written for a musical, and I think you'll find it interesting. But we're going to close out with Get Happy right now. And let me say this, as soon as we finish playing this, we're going to come right on down here. We want to come out and say hello to you, okay? We want to come out and meet you and say hello and just give you a thank you for being here with us tonight. So thank you, thank you, thank you for being here. Get happy.
Shake all your cares away. Sing hallelujah, come on, get happy. Get ready for the judgment day. The sun is shining, come on, get happy. The Lord is waiting, take your hand. Shout hallelujah, come on, get happy. We're going to the promised land. We're heading across the river. Wash your sins away in the tide.
Let's go.